whole of squares. So we are studying about determinants. So in determinants, so what is the determinant? Determinant is a function f from m to R, where m is the matrix of order n cross n with real entries. Okay, this is what determinant. Determinant is a function from m to R. Here, if there exist a real number, unique real numbers for every matrix. Okay, for every matrix means it should be a square matrix. Then only we can find the determinant value. Then how to get the value of the determinant? Or else before that, the notation: if A is any matrix, square matrix, then determinant of A can be written as determinant of A, or else you can call it as determinant of A. Okay, right. So if it is of 2 cross 2, suppose A is equal to A1, A2, B1, B2. Okay. Then determinant of A is equal to left topmost corner to right bottom corner. Here, left bottom corner to right topmost corner. So that is A1, B2 minus of D1. A2. This is the procedure for finding the determinant, the value of the determinant. If it is of 3 cross 3, suppose the matrix A is 3 cross 3, A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3, and C1, C2, C3. So it is 3 cross 3 matrix. Determinant of A. Determinant of A is equal to, we know already, so convert into 2 cross 2 matrix from A1 into bracket B2 C3 minus C2 B3 minus of A2 into bracket B1 C3 minus C1 B3 plus A3 into bracket B1 C2 minus C1 B2. This is the procedure. Means expanding through first row A1 positive A1 into bracket B2 C3 C2 B3. Here minus sign will come because here first row first column element minus 1 raised to 1 plus 1. That is positive, sorry, plus 2. Minus 1 raised to even number means you get positive. Here, first row, second column element, it is first row, second column means 1 plus 2, 3 will come. So, minus 1 raised to odd number. If you get minus 1 raised to odd number, again you get minus sign only. That's why here minus sign will come. Again, here A3. A3 is first row, third column, 1 plus 3. 1 plus 3 is even, minus 1 raised to even number means again positive, okay? That's why here positive. So similarly you can expand through first column also, second column also, third column also. So you know the procedure. Next one, we are discussing about examples. Now consider the fifth main question. We have seen two questions from the fifth main. Next, we will consider third one. Okay. Determinant of evaluate 3 minus 4, 5, 1, 1 minus 2, 2, 3, 1. Is equal to expanding the first row 3 into bracket, eliminate this row and column, then remaining matrix is 1 minus 2 3 1 1 into 1 1 माइनस 3 इंटू माइनस 2 इट इज माइनस 6 माइनस साइन. ओके हियर माइनस ऑफ माइनस 4 इंटू एलिमिनेट दिस कॉलम एंड रो रिमेनिंग पार्ट्स 1 इंटू 1 1 माइनस 2 इंटू माइनस 2 इट इज माइनस 4 then plus 5 is the red 5 into bracket 1 into 3 3 2 into 1 2 which is equal to 3 into bracket 1 minus into minus plus 1 plus 6 will come here minus into minus plus 4 as it is 1 plus 4 plus 5 into bracket 3 minus 2 is 1. Simplify this. 3 into 7 plus 4 into 5 plus 5 into 1. 3 7s are 21, 4 5s are 20 plus 5 is equal to 21 plus 20, 41, 41 plus 5, 46. This is the answer. Similarly, we take fourth example. Determinant 2 minus 1 minus 2 0 2 minus 1 3 minus 5 0. See, this also for the 3 cross 3, then expand 2. Here, if I expand through first column, what will happen here? 2 into bracket, expand the first column. Okay, in previous example, the example we have expanded to first row. This example, if I expand to first column, what will happen? Because 0 is there, no? It will be easy for calculation. So that's why we consider first column 2 into bracket. 2 into 0, 0, minus sign, minus 5 into minus 1, plus 5, sorry, 5. Here, minus, we leave this because 0 into anything is equal to 0. Next, we will consider this one plus 3 into minus 1 into minus 1 plus 1 minus 1 2 into minus 2 minus 4. And simplify 2 into minus 5. Here, 0 minus 5 is minus 5 plus 3 into 1 plus 4. 2 5s are minus 10 plus 3 into 5. 3 into 5, 15 is equal to 5. Okay. Same example, you can expand to the last row also. If you expand to the last row also, you get the same answer. Let's see, try from it. Oh. Main question 6. Question number 6. If A is equal to, here matrix it is, 1, 1, minus 2, 2, 1, minus 3, 5, 4, minus 9. Find determinant of A. Expand it. Determinant of A is equal to, expand row, first row, 1 into bracket, minus 9, 1 into minus 9, minus 9, minus sign in between, 4 into minus 3, it is minus 12, minus 1 again, minus 1, here middle value minus will come, plus 1 is there, plus 1, leave this column and row, 2 into minus 9, minus 18, 5 into minus 3, minus 15. 15. Then plus half minus 2. Here, third element plus will come, but here element is minus 2. So minus 2 into bracket. Leave this column and row. 2 fours are 8 minus 5. Then simplification 1 minus 9 minus into minus plus 12 minus 1 into bracket minus 18 minus into minus plus 15 minus 2 plus into minus minus 2 8 minus 5 plus 3. Simplify this 1 into plus 3 minus 9 plus 12 minus plus 3 minus 1 minus 18 plus 15 here minus 3 minus 6 is equal to 3 plus 3 minus 6. 3 plus 3 6, 6 minus 6 and that's it. Okay. Then next one. Question number 7. Find the value of x. Find the value of x if determinant of 2, 4, 5, 1 is equal to determinant of 2x, 4, 6, x. Okay, this is the question. We need to find the x value. Very simple. So it is not matrix, remember it. Here we cannot equate the values, first row, first column element, first row, first column corresponding elements, because it is determinant. So in the determinant, we need to solve this left hand side and right hand side, then equate. So how to solve? It is 2 cross 2. Its order is 2 cross 2. So 2 into 1. 2 minus 5 fours are 20 is equal to 2x into x. 2x square minus 6 fours are 24. Then simplify this. Left hand side minus 18 is equal to 2x square minus 24. Take that minus 24 to left hand side. Plus 24 minus 18 is equal to 2x square. 24 minus 18 means it is 6 plus 6 is equal to 2x square. So x square is equal to 6 by 2, it is plus 3. Then x is equal to plus or minus root 3. Okay. This is not how to find the x value. Same time, one more question is that finding x. 2, 3, 4, 5 is equal to x3 2x5. Same type, it is also same type. We need to find the x value. Yes, 2 5s are 10, 4 3s are 12 is equal to 5x minus 6x. Simplify, minus 2 is equal to 5x minus 6x minus x, so x is equal to plus 2. Okay. This is finding x value. Same type, one more question. Question number 8 we will consider. Question number 8. If determinant x 2 18 x is equal to 6 2 18 6, then x is equal to, what is the value of x? Simple again, left hand side, x square minus 18 2s are 36 is equal to 36 get cancelled, we get 0, x square minus 36 is equal to 0, we get x square is equal to 36, x square is equal to 36, x is equal to plus or minus, yes, 6. So taking square root of 36, we will get plus or minus 6. Okay, this is what, how to expand, if it is of 3 cross 3 or if it is of 2 cross 2 matrix, then how to find the value, how to evaluate the determinant. Okay, then next, some properties of determinant. There are some simple properties are there. First property. So, what is that first property? Important properties for solving. By using that property, we need to solve the examples. Need to find the determinant by using properties. In that first property, the value of the determinant remains same the value of the determinant remains same if we interchange rows into columns. We interchange rows into columns. Means there is no change in the value of the determinant after changing rows into column or column into rows. Okay. If delta we consider, delta means determinant. If it is of 3 cross 3 matrix, delta is determinant of the given matrix A. Given determinant it is, suppose A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. Okay. It is of 3 cross 3 order. Then delta dash will write it. Delta dash means after interchanging rows into columns, means the values, the elements of first row can be written in first column, second row in second column, third row in third row, just like transpose. Okay, so delta dash is equal to what? Before that, so we will calculate this, we will expand this first one. Delta is equal to, after expanding, what value we get? A1 into bracket B2 C3 minus C2 B3. Okay. Minus of A2 into bracket B1 C3 minus C1 B3 plus A3 into bracket B1 C2 minus C1 B2. Okay. This is determinant, the value of the determinant of the given matrix. Okay. Then delta dash, or else you can simplify A1 B2 C3 minus A1 C2 B3 minus A2 B1 C3 minus C2 minus plus A2 C1 B3 plus A3 B1 C2 minus A3 C1 D2. Okay. So after expanding the first row, we got this. Okay. This is delta C. Then after interchanging, what we get? Delta dash we can call. Delta dash is equal to right determinant. First row elements in first column. So A1, A2, A3. Here B1, B2. B3. Second column elements in, second row elements in second column. third row elements in third column. Okay. So after interchange, now also we can expand through first row. Expand through first row means A1 into bracket B2 C3 minus B3 C2 minus sign B1 into bracket. Here this row and column A2 C3 minus A3 C2 plus C1 into bracket A2 B3 minus A3 B2. Here A1 B1 C1 A2 B2 C2 A3 B3 C3, these are all real entries. Okay, then simplification A1 into B2 C3 minus A1 B3 C2 minus B1 A2 C3 minus into minus plus B1 A3 C2 plus C1 A2 B3 minus C1 A3 B2. Okay. Just you check these two. This is delta dash after transpose. Okay, interchanging goes into column. Here A1 B2 C3 is there. A1 B2 C3 is there. Minus sign A1 C2 B3 minus sign A1 C2 B3 is there. Okay, same. Minus A2 B1 C3. A2 B1 C3. Okay. Next A2 C1 B3. A2 C1 B3. A2 C1 B3. Okay. A3 B1 C2. A3 B1 C2 minus A3 C1 B2. A3 C1 B2. Okay. Same elements. Okay. Therefore, we can call delta is equal to delta dash. After interchanging rows into columns, again we get the same determinant. Right? So this is first property. Okay. Means there is no change in the value of the determinant after changing rows into columns. Next property. Property number 2. In the determinant, if you interchange any two rows or any two columns, in the determinant, if interchanging any two rows or columns, any two rows or any two columns, then the value of determinant, value of determinant changes by its sign. What it means? We need to interchange any two rows. Means two rows, if I write A1, A2, B1, B2. Interchanging two rows means in place of A1, A2, write B1, B2. Next A1, A2. This is what interchanging two rows. Column means A2 B1 B2 A1 B1 interchanging columns. Okay. So after interchanging, the value will be same, but the sign changes. If we get a positive for the given determinant, positive value, the same value will come after interchanging any two rows or any two columns. Either column or either rows are interchanged by that. Value same बर्तता, but model बंदी दिनोंता था sign हो, model बंदी दिनोंता sign change आया, model plus बंदी दिया, model minus बर्तता, model minus बंदा ना, मतलब plus आया, okay, so just we'll see that that is delta. Delta means it is given the interval same a1, a2, a3, b1, b2, b3, c1, c2, c3. 3 cross 3 order. So we know after expanding delta value a1 into bracket b2 c3 minus c2 b3 minus a2 into bracket b1 c3 minus c1 b3 plus a3 into bracket b1 c2 minus c1 b2. Okay. Next, a1 b2 c3 minus a1 c2 b3 minus a2 b1 c3 plus a2 c1 b3 plus a3 b1 c2 minus a3 c1 b2. Okay, so this is the given vector after expanding given vector. The delta dash means interchanging any two rows or any two columns. If I change, interchange two rows, means write first row elements in second row, second row elements in first row, b1, b2, b3, a1, a2, a3, and what will be the value of this determinant c1, c2, c3. Okay, again expanding through first row b1 as it is into bracket a2 c3 minus sign c2 a3 minus b2 into bracket a1 c3 minus sign c1 a3 plus b3 into bracket a1 c2 minus sign c1 a2. So or else you can simplify b1 a2 c3 minus b1 c2 a3 minus b2 a1 c3 plus b2 c1 a3 plus b3 a1 c2 minus b3 c1 a2. Just observe the values. The b1 a2 c3 is there, b1 a2 c3 is there, here positive, here negative. Then a1 b2 c3, a1 b2 c3, here positive, here negative. Next, a1 c2 b3, a1 c2 b3, negative is there, a1 c2 b3, positive is there. So whatever the value of the determinant of delta is there, the same but opposite side. Okay, here if you take minus and outside, you can write it as delta dash is equal to minus of delta. Okay, so this is property number 2. Then property number 3 we'll see. Simple properties. Third property. Third property is in the determinant if any two rows or columns are identical, any two columns are identical, then the value of determinant is 0. Value of determinant is 0. Okay. Identical means A1, A2, A3. Again A1, A2, A3. C1, C2, C3. Okay. So identical means first row and second row. Elements are same. Corresponding elements are same here. Okay. Here also A1, here also A1. That's why we get what? Both R1 and R2 are identical. Then, what is the value of this? Expand it. A1 into bracket A2 C3 minus C2 A3 minus A2 into bracket A1 C3 minus C1 A3 plus A3 into bracket A1 C2 minus C1 A2. Okay. Simplify, what will get? A1 A2 C3 minus A1 C2 A3 minus A2 A1 C3 plus A2 C1 A3 plus A3 A1 C2 minus A3 C1 A2. Okay. Here A1, A2, C3 is there. A1, A2, C3 is there. Here positive, negative, what will get cancelled. Next. A1, A3, C2. A1, A3, C2. A1, A3, C2. Positive, negative, or 0. A2, C1, E3. A2, C1, E3. Because these are all real elements, okay, is equal to at 0. If any two rows or any two columns are identical, then the value of determinant is 0. This is third property. Next we'll go for fourth property. Property number 4. What is that fourth property in the determinant? If all elements, of any one row, or each element of any one row or column multiplied by same scalar k, then the value of new determinant is k times the given determinant. So instead of all elements, we can consider if each element of any one row, or any one column, each element of any one row or any one column is multiplied by same scalar. Every element is multiplied by same scalar k, then the value of new determinant is k times the given determinant. given determinant is delta is equal to, this is A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. It is given determinant. New determinant is delta dash we consider, that is delta dash is equal to first row. Suppose if I consider first row, each element of first row is multiplied by k, scalar quantity, k into A1, k into A2, k into A3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. Okay. The value of this determinant is equal to k times of that delta. We need to prove this. K times of the given determinant. Okay. We need to prove that. How to prove? Which is equal to k into A1 into bracket B2 C3 minus C2 B3, okay, minus k into A2 into bracket B1 C3 minus C1 B3 plus k into A3 into bracket B1 C2 minus C1 B2. So in each term k is common. If I take it outside, k into A1 B2 C3 minus C2 B2 minus A2 into bracket B1 C3 minus C1 B3 plus A3 into bracket B1 C2 minus C1 B2, which is equal to k into, it is nothing but delta. If you expand this, we'll get this one. So already we have expanded in previous, or else you in the first property we can call it as k into delta. It is nothing but here first row is multiplied by the same scalar. You can take k common from the each term. Okay, and also k into determinant of delta, right? This fourth property. Fifth one, property number 5. In the determinant, fifth property in the determinant, each element of or all element of any one row, each element of any row or column is sum of two quantities. Each element of any row or column is sum of two quantities, then the determinant can be expressed, and the determinant can be expressed as sum of two determinants of the same order. Sum of the determinants of the same order. What is the meaning of this? Let delta. Suppose in first row we have expressed each element of first row as sum of two quantities, a1 plus alpha, a2 plus beta, a3 plus gamma. Okay. B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. So, this five determinant can be here two quantities in the first row, each element of the first row can be written as sum of A1 plus A alpha can be written as sum of the expressed as sum of the two determinants, that is A1, A2, A3. B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3, plus alpha, beta, gamma, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. Like this we can express. Okay. Now, Delta is equal to. We need to prove this, okay? Delta is equal to expanded A1 plus alpha into bracket B2 C3 minus C2 B3 minus of A2 plus beta into bracket B1 C3 minus C1 B3 plus A3 plus gamma into bracket B1 C2 minus C1 is equal to first element, A1 is there, A1 into bracket B2 C3 minus C2 B3. Okay. Minus A2 into bracket this one. B1 C3 minus C1 B3. Plus next A3 into bracket B1 C2 minus C1 B3. Okay. Then next row plus, just we have multiplied here by A1, next by A2, next by A3. Next we will consider by alpha. Alpha into bracket B2 C3 minus C2 B3. Okay. Minus into plus minus sign beta into bracket B1 C3 minus C1 B3. Plus gamma into bracket B1 C2 minus C1. Okay. So this is expansion of A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. Okay. You can write this A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. Plus, this is expansion of, here in place of A1, A2, A3, alpha, beta, gamma is there. Remaining is same. B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. This is property number 5. Right? Understood? If any row or column, each element are expressed as or written as sum of the two quantities, then the value of determinant can be expressed as sum of two determinants of the same order. Property number 6. Property number 6. determiner in the determiner is any row or column. Any row or column means each element of any row or any column. Each element of any row or any column is multiplied by same scalar k. Already we have seen the fourth property k and added to corresponding elements of any other row or column. If you consider row here also row we need to consider. If you consider column, here also we need to consider column. Any other row or column, then the value of determinant, then the value of determinant unaltered. Means the value will not change. Okay. So given matrix is given determinant A1, A2, A3. B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3 it is. Okay. Then, means each element of any row or any column is added here K1 multiplied. R1 means here you apply it. R1 implies K into R1. K into R1 plus R2. K into R1 plus R2. Or else you can call it as R2 implies R2 plus K into R1. R2 plus K into R1. What will happen? A1, A2, A3. So R2 implies K plus R1, K plus B1 plus K into A1, B2 plus K into A2, B3 plus K into then C1, C2, C3. Okay. Therefore, the value of the determinant will not change. Same. As we expand this, we should get same as delta. Whatever delta dash is there, delta dash determinant also same as delta. You can solve it home. Okay? Just expand it. Expand row, second row, the expand row, first column, whatever you can do, you may be same answer. The answer will not change. You can apply for R1 also, no change. Okay. problem. R3 also required. C1, C2, C3 also required. Property number 7. In the determinant, if all elements of any row, all elements of any row or column are zeros, okay, all elements of any row or column are zeros, then the value of determinant is zero, or else you can call it as vanish. Vanish means zero, right? Means suppose delta is equal to any row or any column. If the value, if the elements of any row or any column are zeros, D1, D2, D3, C1, C2, C3. Okay. Here, in first row, all elements are equal to zeros. Then expand 0 into D2, C3 minus C2, D3 minus 0 into bracket D1, C3 minus C1, D3 plus 0 into bracket D1, C2. Here 0 into anything is equal to 0. 0 into anything is equal to 0. 0 into anything is equal to 0. So 0 minus 0 plus 0, we get 0. So this is property number 7. Then property number 8. Property number 8. In the determinant, if each element of one side of the principal diagonal, principal diagonal is zero, each element is zero above the principal diagonal or below the principal diagonal, all elements are equal to zero, then the value of determinant is product of principal diagonal elements, product of diagonal elements or principal diagonal elements. Okay, what it means? One side of the principal diagonal means, suppose delta is equal to A1, A2, A3, here B2, D3, C3. So this is principal diagonal. This is principal diagonal. Below that principal diagonal, all elements are zeros. Okay, all elements are zeros. Then value of this determinant is equal to A1, B2, C3. Means product of principal diagonal elements. These are the principal diagonal elements, A1, B2, C3. Okay. So product of principal diagonal elements, that is A1, B2, C3. Or else you can expand it. Expand through first column. You get the answer. Expand through first column. Because zeros are more in first column. That's why expand from first column A1 into bracket B2 C3 minus 0 into B3 0 minus A2 into bracket element is row column and row. 0 into C3 is 0. 0 into B3 is also 0. Plus A3 into bracket. Negative this column and row. 0 into 0 is 0. 0 into B2 is 0. Is equal to A1, B2, C3. It is also 0. It is also 0. 0 into anything is equal to 0. So remaining A1, B2, C3. These are 8 important properties. You need to remember, very important for solving the examples. You need to apply these properties for solving the examples. So such type questions we will ask for 4 marks. By using properties, prove that. Okay, we will ask for 4 marks. So in the part D, we will ask this question. Okay. So the examples we will see in the next video. How to solve by using or by applying the properties, how to solve the examples or how to prove the determinants. Okay. Thank you.